There is war. It's a war.
The Plebeian View's goal is to be a leading voice on creating a fair and equitable world where all people are entitled to life, liberty, and happiness.
How you doing? This is Muata Greene, bringing you the Plebeian View podcast for May 2023. On this podcast, we'll be talking about a lot of information and give you ways to find out more about what we talk about. First of all, we're going to talk about May Day, which was May 1st, which was last week. Then we're going to talk about Mental Health Awareness Month, which May is. We're going to talk about EMS Week, which is May 16th through 21st. And then I'm going to talk briefly about Malcolm X's birthday, which is the 19th of this month. So stay tuned for the Plebeian View, and we'll get right into it. Let's start out with May Day, which was May 1st. Yes, May Day is Labor Day throughout most of the world, not in the United States and Canada, but most of the world. And it's very interesting how the struggle or a celebration of labor that started in the United States is not celebrated in the United States like it should be. May Day goes back to the struggles of the late 19th century, the struggle for the 8-hour day and decent working conditions. It was adopted by the Second Congress of the International throughout the world in 1891. But in this country, it got negative connotations being associated with anarchists, socialists, and communists who were about organizing it and bringing it to fruition. So May Day is a very important day throughout the world. Most of the world celebrates it, like I said, a tribute to the working class. I'm going to give you some books that are good to check out for a better history of May Day. And also let you know, you can check out in the Tri-City News last week, my article was out about May Day, the real Labor Day. Okay, here's some suggestions for May Day readings. Haymarket Revisited by William Alderman. Boston Workers, A History of Labor by James R. Green and Hugh Donahue. And the final one I want to recommend is The Making of the English Working Class. If you want more information on that, definitely email me and I'll be glad to send you the particulars. In this segment, I want to talk about Mental Health Awareness Month and EMS Appreciation Week. For those who don't know it, I am a retired EMS worker, 26 years with the Fire Department of New York. As you notice in the background, that's my EMS union shirt. EMS Awareness Week is May 16th to 21st every year. That's when community gives appreciation to the EMS workers who are there for them in time of need, who are essential workers all the time, not just during emergencies or when we have pandemics, but we're there to help deliver babies, you know, people who got a bad asthma attack or feeling sick, have no way of getting to the hospital. We're there to help people out and to treat them as we would treat our own. EMS is not just a job, it's a lifestyle to take care of fellow human beings and to make sure they are okay. I come from the train of thought that healthcare is a human need and a human right. It's not just for those who have the money to afford the best. Everybody's health should be taken care of. And this country doesn't have healthcare for all like a lot of countries do. Like Cuba, I've been to Cuba many times, where healthcare is a human right and it's free for all. So as an EMS worker, as I said, for 26 years of my life, I appreciate what I have done for humanity and I do miss it, even though it's very stressful and a hard job to do. So when you see your EMS worker during the week of the 16th to 21st, make sure you say hello to them and say, tell them how much you appreciate them. Okay. Now let's move on to mental health awareness. That's another very important topic, mental health awareness. Because in this country, once again, we deny mental health as real illness. Mental health is what your brain has from the day you were born. And it can either sometimes get better or it can get worse. Things that people do, violence, hurting themselves, hurting each other, is a mental health crisis. The brain, we are just finding out more and more about it in the last 15 to 20 years. And we still are at the beginning. The brain controls our whole way in which we view ourselves, view the world around us, and everything else. And coming out of the pandemic, I must say that mental health awareness is needed very much, because I really feel that everybody needs some form of therapy after 2 years or almost 3 years what we went through during the pandemic, and we're still going through now with the economic crisis. So be sure to understand your own mental health. Don't be scared to reach out to a mental health person, a therapist, psychology. Talk to your family and friends. If you see their actions seem beyond what they used to be or what they did before. Because we are here together to help each other and being aware of it. If you Google Mental Health Awareness Month, a lot of stuff will come out. How to recognize signs of mental health disorders. So the main thing is be aware of it and to help ourselves, help each other, and always try to stay in your rational, logical mind. Because your emotional health feeds into your mental health, and that can go all over the place. We all get emotional because they say we're emotional creatures. Is that because we were trained that way? We weren't taught to be rational, critical thinkers. And that's very important in dealing with the balance of our mental health. And finally, I'd like to talk about May 19th, Malcolm X's birthday. He was born 1925, May 19th, 1925. Malcolm X, to me, was a hero because he came out of religion of Islam, narrow so-called black Islam, and became an internationalist. Understand that religion is international. It's not just based on one nationality or one people's. And that religion is a personal thing between you and your God. But he became what I would say a progressive social democrat, a progressive person in his latter years, where he was about creating a better humanity for everybody. So must always remember Malcolm X, celebrate his birthday. Check out his biography by Alex Haley, his autobiography, and know the real Malcolm X, not what the media has told you about him. As we close out this podcast of May 2023, I hope I gave you information to stir your mind and make you think about it. If you have questions, please reach out to me at plebeianview@gmail.com. So remember what we always say, in the native tongue of Kiswahili, tuta nana, until we meet again. Stay safe and continue to learn more.
Significance than the color of his eyes. Miss a war that until the basic human rights are equally guaranteed to all.